Pop videos have become pretty big business in Britain. Indeed, they seem to make them virtually anywhere. We're in Birmingham on a bitterly cold January afternoon, and behind us, the Birmingham-based band UB40 are making a pop video. This particular video was costing a relatively modest £6,000. A small production company called Directors International supplied the camera crew, a derelict car plant served as backdrop, and only one of the eight members of the band, the lead singer Ali Campbell, was featured. Why does your band UB40, why do they make pop videos? Why do you make them?
Same reason as everybody else, to sell a record. Purely as an advertisement, you know, that it can be put on shows in Europe and TV shows that we can't appear. If there's two records out and one hasn't got a video with it, the record, whether it's better or not, it could be a terrible record. The one with the video will get airplay. It'll get shown.
On average, about 20 pop videos are made in Britain every week. They can cost £100,000 or more. And the record companies are now tending to wait for a single to get into the charts before making the accompanying video. But at the same time, videos remain a vital way of selling records, particularly in America.
MTV Music Television. Don't get caught without it. Your first video music channel. Take MTV to go.
Do you know what the best part of MTV is?
Yep.
It's on 24 hours a day.
Right.
It's in stereo.
Yep.
It's got your favorite music.
Uh-huh.
It's got VJs.
Yep.
And guest VJs.
Yep.
There's music news.
Uh-huh.
It's got interviews.
Yep.
Concerts and specials.
Uh-huh.
Hey, so how come you know so much about MTV?
Because I haven't turned it off for 18,240 hours.
With pop videos as the basic staple of MTV, even the obscurest British band has a chance of establishing itself in the States without necessarily having even toured there. The problem is this kind of visual ingenuity doesn't come cheap.
I think that the record industry has been spending tens of millions of pounds in making three-minute promo video clips and have found that that's become a very expensive way of promoting records, and that what they've had to do is to find other ways to get some of that money back. And one of the things that we've been doing is to put together compilations of promo videos and sell them as one-hour programmes, both to the home video markets and to the television markets, which help the record companies to get their money back.
As a result, record stores as well as video outlets are beginning to stock one-hour music videos. The Wham video, currently riding high in the music video charts, has sold some 40,000 copies at just under £20 a time. So it's evident the business is there, and more music videos are now scheduled for release. This year, some 300 compared with 150 last year. There are three kinds of music video. First, the compilation video. The Rolling Stones currently have one out made up of their recent pop promos and skillfully edited old footage. Secondly, and rather easier to put together, there is the concert video. In this instance, a film record of a single concert by Dire Straits. Finally, what's known as the concept music video, whereas in the case of Michael Jackson's Thriller, the artist not only sings, but is required to dance and act out a simple narrative. Thriller has sold 1 million copies worldwide, making it the best-selling music video to date.
But now they're beginning to realise that they can actually put out something that's conceptual, something that has a storyline, something that's like a documentary or like a mini feature film with music in it, a mini musical, if you like.
And presumably make money doing so.
And make money doing so, certainly. And create, if you like, a new art form. I mean, we're actually talking about a completely new art form here.
Certainly, there's a considerable amount of visual flair already involved in music video. The American John Landis, who's directed several feature films, was responsible for Thriller.
We'll just try it once more.
In Britain, there's Julian Temple, who looks after the Rolling Stones videos, and the partnership of Kevin Godley and Lol Cream, who directed the Two Tribes video for Frankie Goes to Hollywood. There's plenty of imaginative filmmaking here, but costs are escalating.
When we started, you could spend, say, £5,000... and make a fairly reasonable film, you know, a 16mm film, you know, a fairly reasonable 3-minute performance. Whereas now, I'd say the standard is £30,000. You know, yeah, the doors are all being closed. It's like record companies have really got a grip again. You know, they can sign an act and say, well, we've got to put all this